Hey guys, it's Bro, You Whack, and we want to know something I haven't noticed up until this very point. It's almost been a full year since the May cinematic came out, and in November, it's going to be a full year since we got our last cinematic with Reinhardt. And that's what I want to talk about today, talk about the cinematics that we need to see in Overwatch, because I think I speak for everyone that we don't need the cinematics from Overwatch characters, we don't need the story. But we really love it, and we really do like it, and we appreciate it at the end of the day. So I just want to talk about some ideas that I would love to see, but also some stuff that we just need to see in general, not just based on ideas or stuff that would be cool. We need these loose ends tied from the Overwatch story that, you know, this game isn't really needing at this point, but that we would just like to see. So whenever it comes to cinematics, there's always two different themes for all of these. This is important for me to say because, well, this is gonna lead into the ideas that we need to see for future cinematics. So the first theme for these cinematics is always some sort of mission, always some sort of skit. You already know the heroes, but the main point of the cinematic being brought before us is the story that's being told right before our very eyes. The second theme is that it's always telling the backstory for a specific hero. You don't know this hero, you don't know what the idea of this hero is, and the idea of the cinematic being brought before our eyes is to tell the backstory for these heroes. So the first cinematic that we absolutely need to see is going to take under the first theme, which is some sort of mission, which is going to be some sort of skit, not really tell the backstory. Well, at least it may even tell the backstory of a specific hero, we don't know, but it's going to be branching off of the infiltration cinematic. So if you don't know how the cinematic works, you really should, because it's been almost 2 years since this one came out. But Sombra and Talon break into like this Russian army headquarters, and then she goes into like the main office where the leader is, and then she just wants to partner up with this Russian leader, and then she goes. But then the Russian leader doesn't want to partner up with Talon, so she brings in the big heavy guns and says, "I think you know what you need to do." And then here comes the big gun, Zarya, and then she says, "Huh, I believe I do." And then that's it. Sombra got away, but now Zarya knows what she needs to do, but what is it? What does she need to do? This is why it's the first cinematic that we need to see. We might not necessarily care about Zarya. Again, Zarya is not the most popular hero of all time, but this was intentionally left on a cliffhanger to further tell the story of Talon, further tell the story of how Zarya fits into the Overwatch team, and could possibly tell the backstory of Zarya itself. Yes, I said that this is gonna be like sharing the first theme, which is like some sort of mission, some sort of just something like that, but this could easily tell the backstory of how Zarya got so buff, got the way that she is, got into like this Russian army or whatnot. It could be the perfect loose end tying cinematic ever. You're gonna see that in a lot of my arguments saying why we need the cinematic so bad is just because of loose ends. Infiltration is one of the few cinematics that has the biggest loose end ever, because now Zarya is introduced into the lore of Overwatch, but what is her purpose? You know what I'm trying to say? We don't know her backstory, and we also don't know what she's gonna do to Talon organization. Is she gonna go to Reaper's headquarters and fist it? Okay, let's just move on. Let's not get graphic here. The next cinematic that I would absolutely love to see is an Ana Amari and Widowmaker co-cinematic. So, we all kind of know how Ana lost her eyes. Because she was in a Call of Duty lobby, she was talking trash to Widowmaker. Widowmaker challenged her to a 1v1 battle on Rust in Modern Warfare 2. And boom, snipes her eye out. Now, I might be paraphrasing here. That might not be exactly how it went down. But that's also kind of how it went down. Widowmaker sniped Ana Amari's eye out when they're in like a 1v1 duel or whatnot. So they can't really tell a 10-minute cinematic story based on just that event. However, you can build a backstory that tells a story for both of these heroes, both leading up to the event where Widowmaker actually snipes Ana's eye out. Like I said before, loose ends are going to be a popular argument for a lot of these cinematics and why they needed to be, but especially for Widowmaker. Blizzard wants to tell the backstory for Widowmaker so bad without telling the backstory for Widowmaker, because they have sprays showing Widowmaker with her husband. They have the Talon skin before she got her blue skin, and they even have an emote of her ballet dancing back in her days of being a ballet dancer. But still, we do not have a backstory for Widowmaker. But could you imagine just seeing just flashbacks of both of these heroes just living their lives up until the point of their big ferocious, well, probably not ferocious because they're snipers, but big epic one snipe battle between the two, alongside Ana Amari's backstory of her joining Overwatch Overwatch of her joining, you know, Soldier 76 and Reinhardt and all of them. Could you imagine that happening? That would just be so cool and just such an epic buildup of two amazing heroes. And boom, we finally know the backstory of two more heroes rather than just one. I just think that would be a really cool and unique idea and something we really haven't seen in a lot of these cinematics, and that is telling a story for two different heroes at the same time. I mean, we see stuff like with dragons with Hanzo and Genji, but it doesn't tell the backstory. So that's why I really like that idea, but it also feeds into my next idea and something that would tell a lot of the reasons why these heroes are to be, and that is a story with Mercy, Genji, and Zenyatta. So this cinematic really just focuses on Genji and his story. So I guess you could say this not only tells the backstory of Genji, but further tells what he's about and why he is the way he is today. So as you guys know, how Mercy is related to Genji is because Mercy does save Genji after Hanzo completely demolishes him. So he was banished from the family, but he also almost dies, but Mercy's able to save him, patch him up, and make him into the cyborg ninja that he is today. And then from there, I want to say he kind of just goes on his own journey and just kind of discovers who he is, really finds out why he's half cyborg, half human, but he also trains with Zenyatta. This is where Zenyatta comes into play and really just tells his story of how he knows Genji and just trains him and makes him into the awesome cyborg ninja that he is today too. The story really isn't to focus on the backstory or really just the heroes of Mercy and Zenyatta, rather than just focus on Genji, but really introduce a lot of these heroes into the cinematic lore. But what it's also supposed to do is tell the backstory and further tell the future story of Genji, and it all leads up to the Dragon Cinematic, because as you guys know, in the Dragon Cinematic, Genji goes back to Hanamura where he fights Hanzo, and that's where he actually discovers that Genji is Hanzo's brother. So I think that would just be a cool little tie-in with the Dragon Cinematic, but also tell the story of Genji. So with a lot of these cinematic ideas, they have some sort of deeper story or deeper meaning that really can't be told in the game. It needs to be told in the form of a movie, in the form of a cinematic where we can really appreciate the hero a little bit more. But this next idea has none of that, and it's just a fun, happy cinematic. With d.va, again, she's just one of those heroes that a lot of people just love just because of what she represents. This gamer girl who's also very powerful, who stands up for herself, who has control, you know, that kind of thing. So now it would just be pretty much a day in the life of d.va. Again, it might be something dumb, it might be something very gimmicky, but we don't really, like we do know the story of d.va. She's this famous Korean gamer girl who streams her battles on, like, Twitch or whatnot, but wouldn't you want to see that in the form of a cinematic? Like, wouldn't you want to actually see that? That's why I think that would just be a cool idea of a cinematic. Just a day in the life of d.va, not really how she fits into Overwatch, not really her backstory, just how she is as a gamer girl. I think that would be a cool idea. Some of you might think it's stupid and just want those storytelling cinematics, but, you know, d.va's one of those heroes that doesn't really need that deep meaning story. Would just be a cool cinematic and be a fun hero to watch. Now, this next cinematic is going to share the same vibe as the first one, and that is tying a big loose end of how this hero came about, but this is going to be the story of how Doomfist broke out of jail, and I'm assuming rejoined Talon and stole his Doomfist back. So, if you guys remember, it was told that Doomfist broke out of jail, went to Nubani, stole the Doomfist Gauntlet from the payload that we moved throughout Nubani, and again, I'm assuming he joined the Talon organization. I'm guessing, because we don't really know for sure what really happened, because there is no cinematic, Blizzard was, I'm just kidding, I'm sure it's hard to bring cinematics, and that's why they're not bringing it, but it would just be a cool story to really just show how Doomfist came about. But what I would love to see, the concept, if I can write a script, a quick little script of how it would go about, if you guys remember, the old Nubani had a lot of advertisements showing Lucio was gonna have a concert. Well, as you guys know, the Doomfist Gauntlet is there, or at least in the museum, so it would be really cool if Lucio was having this cool concert. It would also bring Lucio into the cinematic lore, and then all of a sudden, boom, Doomfist comes in. Hey, I want my gauntlet back, Lucio. Do you have it? And he's like, dog, I'm just running a DJ show. I ain't got your dude. And then he punches him to the ground because I don't know why Doomfist is just a jerk. He finds his gauntlet, steals it, and then it just causes a big ruckus in Nubani. I mean, as you guys know, Nubani got completely thrashed, at least in the airport. We still don't know why. This is why we need to see more cinematics, but we would really appreciate it when that cinematic actually comes out, because not only will we find out why New Bonnie got thrashed, we'd also find out more about Lucio and his DJing skills, we'd also find out more about Doomfist and the talent organization, so on and so forth. So anyway guys, I know I was all over the place, but I absolutely love cinematics because it's a different side of Overwatch that they don't necessarily need to bring, but it's just something we really do appreciate. And that's why I really wanted to bring this video idea out there, to really just get your thoughts going of what you would want to see. So please comment down below what cinematic you would like to see. Whether it's a backstory for maybe like Symmetra, or maybe Junkrat or whatnot, or maybe it's an actual skit idea like with my Doomfist and Lucio idea cinematics. So anyway guys, I love you guys. Thank you guys for watching. More Overwatch videos to come, and bye.